Hello everyone, welcome to Saur Sir's classes. This is Tushar Shaw, and in this video we will be continuing to solve the JAM 2019 paper, okay, that we were solving since the last two videos. Okay, so yeah, so in the last video we did up till question number 10, and therefore we'll be starting today's video with question number 11. Okay, now question number 11 is obviously a sum, a mathematical sum, as you can see. Okay, so it says that fx is equal to x into e to the power minus ex square. Okay, now a minimum has to be found. Okay, so let us find f dash x. So f dash x is equal to we'll be using this formula, ddx of u into v is equal to u dv by dx plus v du by dx. Okay, so this formula would be used. So firstly we'll be differentiating x. The first term that we'll be getting is this one, plus x into e to the power minus x square into ddx of e to the power minus x square, that is ddx, that is e minus 2x. Okay, this would be equal to 0, or you may say if we take common e to the power minus x square, we will be getting 1 minus x in 2x square. Yeah, x into x 2x square. So 1 minus 2x square is equal to 0. Okay. Now e to the power minus x square cannot be 0, because that is a function that we have defined. Okay, so therefore 1 minus 2x square must be equal to 0. Okay, or 1 is equal to 2x square, or x is equal to plus minus 1 by root 2. Okay, x is equal to plus minus 1 by root 2. Okay, so in the option you can see that so we'll not be taking the plus option, we'll be taking the minus option over here, because we are, the minimum has to be found. Okay, minimum. So x will be for x equal to at minus half, the minimum value for fx is found, and therefore minus half would be the answer. Now option D in the options has x equal to minus 2, and therefore option D is the correct option. Okay. Moving on to the next question. Question number 12. Okay. It says the correct option for the number of bending modes of vibration for each of H2O, CH2 and SO2 molecules respectively are. Okay. The molecules given are H2O, CH2 and SO2. Okay. So the structure, let me draw the structures of H2O. This is H2O, we have lone pairs over here. Okay, CH2 like CO2 that we have drawn in the last video. Okay, and SO2 has the structure like this. Okay, so here would be one lone pair. Yeah, so H2O would be having only one type of bending, one bending mode, that is this way. Okay, this would be this would be the one type of bending mode that is available. Okay, CH2 would be having two types of bending mode, but both of them will be in degenerate state. Okay, like having the same energy. Okay, as we have explained in the last video. Yeah, and SO2 will also acquire, like H2O, it would also be having only one bending mode, and therefore total bending modes for H2O is 1, for CH2 is 2, and for this one is 1. Okay, so 1 2 1, and in the options you can see that option D has 1 2 1, and therefore option D is the correct option. Okay, moving on to the next question, that is the total number of degrees of freedom of HBr molecule that is constrained to the translate along a straight line but does not have any constraint for the rotation and vibration. Okay, now in the HBr, this molecule is this question is kind of controversial. Why I am telling you? Because in the HBr molecule, it is a diatomic molecule, obviously. Okay, diatomic molecule. So for a diatomic molecule, there are total 3 into n, that is 3 into 2, it is 6 degrees of freedom. Okay, among the 6 degrees of freedom, 3 of them are translational. Okay, 2 is rotational and 1 is vibrational. Okay, So the three translational rotations are the translational degrees of freedom are in the three axes, that is x axis, y axis, z axis. Okay, the two rotational ones is like, if you consider this molecule, this is one rotation, this is one rotation, and this is one rotation. Okay, so this is two rotation, and vibration is like this, the molecule is stretching itself. Okay, like the CO2 molecule does. Okay, so there are six modes of degrees of freedom. Okay, now if we, like, question says that the molecule, the this molecule does not have any constraints for rotation or vibration. Okay, so if we cancel out the rotation and the vibrational constraint, we have that total number of degrees of freedom to be equal to 3. Okay, but and obviously in the option D, option D of the question, the option is 3, which is expected to be the correct answer. But what happens is that obviously this is the that should be the correct answer, but in the official answer key from the JAM website, it is seen that for question number 13 we have option number C, that is 4. Okay, 4 as the exact answer. Okay, for right option. Okay, so according to me, according to my knowledge, I would guess that I would obviously prove you, I have already showed it to you that there are three would be the answer, but I don't know whether this is a printing mistake or I don't know. Okay, for that. Okay, so I'll be standing on my ground. So according to my knowledge, I got 3 as the answer, so option D is the correct answer for me. Okay, I am assuming that this was a printing mistake. If now if any other theory comes out, then that is okay. Maybe I know something less. That is not a problem. Okay. Moving on to question number 14. That is, according to the kinetic theory of gases, the ratio of the root mean square velocity of the molecular oxygen and molecular hydrogen at 300 Kelvin is. Okay, so for CRMS, that is the root mean square velocity, the formula is for three dimensional, 3RT by M. Okay, so obviously now the R3 is same, R is same, and the temperature given is 300 for both the cases. So the above part is same, the only change is in the root M. Okay, so let us say CRMS for two molecule oxygen, molecular oxygen is equal to 3RT. Let us say we have over here, so M will be taken in kg obviously. So oxygen has a weight 32 grams per mole. Okay, so so the 0.032, okay, 0.032 would be this case for this case, and the CRMS for H2 would be molecular hydrogen would be 3RT divided by molecular hydrogen has a weight 2, so 0.002. okay, now we have to calculate the ratio of molecular oxygen divided by molecular hydrogen. Okay, so CRMS O2 divided by CRMS H2, this will be getting is root over 3RT by root over 0.032 into 0.002 divided by 3RT. Okay, so 3RT is cancelled out over here. We have root over 0.002 divided by 0.032. okay, so if we cancel, we get 1 divided by 16, which is equal to 1 divided by 4. Okay, so the ratio is 1:4. So in the options, you can see that option C has 1:4 as the answer, and therefore option C is the correct one. Okay, so moving on to the next question, which is question number 15. Okay, so in this question it says that the half life for a chemical reaction A, two products. Okay, so the two half lives are given for two initial concentrations. Okay, let the initial concentration be A and the half life be T half. Okay, now for we know a relation, that is T half 1 divided by T half 2 is equal to A2 divided by A1 to the power N. Okay, this relation is derived from the formula for TR values, that is that we will be doing when I'm just writing down the formula over here. When we will be studying chemical kinetics, then I'll be explaining to you how the this formula is derived. Okay, so for now you just remember this is the formula. Now let us put the values of whatever is given to us. Okay, so for T half 1, let us say T half 1 is 200 seconds and here it is 50 seconds. Okay, and A2 is 0.4 and A1 is 0.1. Okay, so here it is n. So 200 by 50 is equal to 4 and let us say this is or 200 by 50 is equal to 4 and 0.4 divided by 0.1 is also equal to 4 to the power n. So here n will be equal to 1, that is the reaction is first order. Okay, now in the options you can see that just a second, I'm sorry, I used the formula wrong over here. That is what I was like trying to remember. So here would be n minus 1. Okay, so n minus 1, so n minus 1 is equal to 1 or n is equal to 2, or the reaction would be second order. Okay, so the for the second order reaction, obviously the option C here, option C in the given question has option 2, the answer equal to 2, and therefore it is the correct answer. Okay, so yeah, so this was the end of this video. We solved 5 questions and then we will be continuing the next video from question number 16. Okay, so thank you.